dear children, welcome back. Let's begin the third module of last chapter in history, that is part to modernization. In this module, we are going to discuss following topics.
After Meiji restoration, in this module, we are going to understand what are the reformation done by the Meiji government. These are the modernizing of the economy through the growth of industries, strengthening the military and the impact on the daily life of the common people.
After Meiji restoration, children, we have seen that how Japan was progressing towards the modernization. So, during the process of Meiji restoration, several reformation took place and which brought Japan into the modern age. So, let us see these reformation in this module. Number one is modernizing towards the economy. So, when Meiji emperors, they took over the charge in the form of government, then the type of change which first of all took place was the modernization of their economy. How does this happen? This happened by establishing, by bringing change towards the industries. Several industries were established to bring back the economy stable and strong. And next changes took place towards the Meiji restoration was the strengthening of their army, strengthening the power of military. So this happened in the time period of Meiji reformation. And third and very important step took place in the Meiji reformation was change in the life of people. The daily life of people went into great change when the impact of other European countries and Asian countries came into the Japan. So let us see all these things in brief.
Due to the influence of Western technology, as a result, the Industrial Revolution, latest from roughly 1890 to 1930, several factories were built, infrastructures were developed, and Japanese economy quickly went up into the growth. Workers in textile factory, the number of people in manufacturing increased from 7 lakh in 1870 to 4 million in 1913. Most of them worked in unit employing less than 5 people and using neither machinery nor electric power. Over half of those employed in modern factories were women, and it was women who organized the first modern strike in 1886. After 1900s, the number of men began increase, but only in 1930s did male workers begin to outnumber women. The size of factories also began to increase. Factories employ more than 100 workers, just over 1,000 in 1909, and jumped over 2,000 by 1920. The rapid and unregulated growth of industries and the demand for the natural resources such as timber led to the environmental destruction. The leader who brought about the imperial restoration continued to exercise power and even established political parties. Between 1918 and 1931, popularly elected prime minister formed cabinets. Thereafter, they lost power to National Unity Cabinet formed across party lines. The emperor was the commander of the forces, and from 1890 this was interrupted to mean that the army and the navy had independent control. In 1899, the prime minister ordered that only serving generals and admirals could become the ministers. This strengthening of the military, together with the expansion of Japan's colonial empire, was connected with the fear that Japan was at the mercy of the Western powers. This fear was used to silence opposition to the military expansion and to the higher taxes to fund the armed forces. Japan's transformation into the modern society can be seen also in the changes in everyday life. The new home was that of nuclear family, where husband and wife lived as a breadwinner and homemaker. This new concept of domesticity in turn generated demand for the new type of domestic goods, new type of family entertainments, and new forms of housing. In year 1920s, the construction companies made cheap housing available for down payment of 200 yen and monthly installment of 12 yen for 10 years. At this time, when the salary of bank employee was 40 yen per month. After defeat in Second World War, Japan re-emerging as a global economic power. Japan's attempt to carve out the colonial empire ended with the defeat by the Allied forces. It has been argued that the nuclear bomb were dropped in Hiroshima and Nagasaki to shorten the war. But on the other hand, this destruction and suffering caused unnecessarily. Under US-led occupation, Japan was demilitarized and a new constitution introduced. Agrarian reforms, the establishment of trade unions, and the attempt of dismantle large monopoly houses that dominated the Japanese economy. Now the political parties were revived and the first post-war election held in 1946, where women voted for the first time. The rapid rebuilding of Japanese economy after scattering defeat was called as the post-war miracle. 1964 Olympics first time held in Tokyo in Japan. In 1960s saw the growth of civil society movement as industrialization had been pushed with the utter disregard to the effect on the health and environment. From the mid 1980s there has been an increasing decline in the interest of environmental issues as Japan enacted some of the strictest environmental control in the world. Today, as a developed country, it faces the challenge of using its political and technological capability to maintain its position as a leading world power.
That's all in this module. Remaining topic of this chapter we are going to cover in the upcoming module. Till then, stay happy, stay safe.
It's time to do some questionnaire. When was the Olympic Games organized in Japan? In year 1949, 1964, 1899 or 1863. Next question is, how long Tokugawa ruler lasted in Japan? It was between 1607 to 1907, between 1589 to 1689 or 1603 to 1807 or 1649 to 1807. Answer all these questions in comment. Thank you for watching.